All right, somebody has a chance right now to win a $25 gift card to Duffy's. We need you to get on the line right now at 888-760-3776, 888-760-ESPN. We are going to do our Ed Morse morsel of truth. So our buddy Louis Heron from Ed Morse Honda, I-95 and Blue Heron Boulevard, is going to join us. He is going to give me two truths and a lie around the cars, the car world. I know nothing about cars. I have to identify which one is true, which one is false, et cetera, et cetera. And you have to just call up at 888-760-3776, 888-760-ESPN. That is the telephone number to play the game here. And you have a chance to win a $25 gift card to Duffy's by just guessing right or wrong. Am I going to be right or wrong? Two truths and a lie, a morsel of truth. I have to identify the lie as part of Ed Morse, morsel of truth. I know nothing about cars, like literally nothing. I can't tell you anything about cars. That is the beauty of this game. Time now for morsel of truth.
Evan Cohen, Ed Morse Honda, and ESPN 106.3 are putting a little extra horsepower behind this game.
Morsel of Truth is presented by Ed Morse Honda, celebrating 75 years of excellence. Join the 1.75 million customers and counting that are backed by Morse with their price protection promise.
It's time to play Morsel of Truth, where your ability to separate fact from fiction can make you a winner. Now here's Evan Cohen and the general manager of Ed Morse Honda, Louis Heron.
Here we go. Before I even bring in Louis, Patrick in Lake Worth, am I going to get this right or wrong? Where are you at, Patrick? Right or wrong?
Say you're going to get it wrong.
Wrong? Okay, no belief in me. And here he is joining us now is our buddy Louis Heron of Ed Morse Honda. That's amazing. Already the wrong answer. All right, before we get into the game and the car questions and the two truths and a lie, for those who have not joined Louis and I the last few Wednesdays, he is Mr. Miami Dolphins. He loves the Miami Dolphins. We said we got to revisit the draft. It's a perfect time to do it. They draft Jalen Waddle out of Alabama 6th. They draft Jalen Phillips out of Miami, the defensive end, 18th. Louis, where are you at? You like the Dolphins draft? You don't like the Dolphins draft?
I do. I feel pretty good. Let's start with the first one. I thought Devontae Smith could have been a better option, but having an Alabama reunion and some chemistry there, and possibly I think Waddle with his skill set could probably do some returns for us, I thought it was a good pick. You want me to go to the next one? Just run them down for you?
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead.
So we got Jalen Phillips. I am in love with this pick. I think, obviously, we wanted a running back, no doubt, and Najee was on the table. But I think the need was bigger than running back when you have somebody like him. I think he's going to do a great job, so I'm pumped about that. The 36th pick, this is where I thought maybe we should have got the running back. I know the Broncos, I think, picked Javonte Williams, if I'm not mistaken, right before.
One pick before, 35. Boy, yeah. I tell you, Louis is on top of this today, man. Unbelievable.
Well, no, you got to watch your fins, man. I mean, but I think, again, I don't know a ton about Holland. So, just what I read on him, I think he's a decent pick. And then, obviously, we finally get a lineman out of Notre Dame with Liam. And I was confused about when we picked up Hunter Long from Boston College, because when we traded down and gave up the third pick, we gave up Kyle Pitts, which would definitely, like we talked before, that would have been a no-brainer. But we got four returning tight ends on the roster. Why would we get this guy? And I don't even know much about him, but I don't know. That was a little...
Well, let's go back to something. So, Louis, you just brought up something very interesting, okay? So this is where I get confused. I don't care as much about the running backs as you do. I think a lot of Dolphins fans get up in arms about that. I don't get it. Like, you can find running backs in the scrap heap. You know that. I know that. So it's maybe you're upset in the moment, but, like, here's the thing. You and I talk after game one, right, on that Wednesday of after game one on the air here on ESPN 106.3. Some guy that we've never heard of runs for 100 yards. It's the one position you can't be surprised about, right? You're never going to feel that. That's never going to happen at quarterback. That is only going to happen at running back, where you and I are going to be like, yo, you ever heard of this guy before this week? And I'm like, no, I never heard of him. You ever heard of him? No, I've never heard of this guy. Like, that happens at the running back position.
Yeah.
So I don't get that concerned about that. What I would continue to question, and I know you're bringing up the number of tight ends, which you're not wrong about, is was this all worth it versus just sitting there at three, Louis, and saying, you know what? Kyle Pitts is going to be, I believe, a Hall of Fame caliber player to the University of Florida. Just take him and worry about the later years and the later years.
I think, honestly, and you know better than I do, I follow the Dolphins, so I don't know how that trajectory of picks would have run down had we done that. Because I like some of the picks we have, but I think if he's on the table and we're at number three, I think you got to grab that guy, man. That's a one.
Okay, so you're saying trajectory of picks, like, so let's say Pitts goes three to you, Dolphins then are not, you know, they stay at 18, which means San Francisco is there at 6 or whatever they were, and then, no, 12, and then Philly, so the order of picks, to your point, the order of picks then is different, and there is a chance that a wide receiver, I guess in theory, could slip to you, or go this way. If a wide receiver was slipping, you trade up from 18 to go up to get that wide receiver who slips, and maybe you end up with Devontae Smith potentially higher up without giving up an extra first they did and without trading around multiple times, and you have Kyle Pitts and a wideout, and now all of a sudden your offense is just nasty.
Now you're nasty, no doubt. So, you know, unfortunately, it's what do they call it, hyperbole. But at this point, it didn't happen, so I guess I got to live with the drafts that I have and the picks. I feel pretty good, man. I mean, I think the rebuilding is over for Miami to a certain degree. I think we've got some players, and we had a good year last year. And, you know, so I'm excited about the coming year. You feel pretty good about the Patriots
I was not on board with the idea of, oh, they got to trade up to get a quarterback, because I'm more of a believer in Cam than maybe other people are. But when you sit there, Louis, and you're like, okay, so this guy's just going to be here when we pick, and Mac Jones is just sitting there. What excites me about this possibility, so in order for this guy to be picked 15, Mac Jones, quarterback, Alabama, two people have to sign off on this happening, Nick Saban and Bill Belichick. Nick Saban has to say to Bill Belichick, his best friend in the business, Bill, yeah, this is the guy. I know I've had other guys. You know I've had A.J. McCarron and Greg McElroy and Tua and Jalen Hurts. You passed on every one of those guys but Tua. This guy I wouldn't pass on. And then Belichick has to say, you're right. I agree with the assessment. I'm good to go on him. Those two guys just signed off on this guy, and they didn't have to move to get him. How can I not be happy about that?
Well, I give you credit, because that's deep thought and that's good understanding of football acumen, because that's probably exactly what happened in the back room, and which tells you he's probably a diamond in the rough, you know. So I don't know. We'll see. I'm hopeful not, because I'm tired of battling you guys over the years. It was somewhat
right. Yeah, you don't. It's not good for you if I'm right about that. But I think back, like, I wanted Jalen Hurts last year. They passed on him. I wanted A.J. McCarron in the past. They passed on him, and they were right. I would take a Greg McElroy type as a backup. They passed on him. Like, so all the guys that I would have thought, oh, Saban, you know, just recommend him to Belichick, obviously didn't, and this guy, he did. Talk with Louis Herron, of course, Ed Morse Honda, I-95 Blue Heron Boulevard. We do this game. It's Morsel of Truth. It's a lot of fun. Louis gives three facts, and I'm doing the air quotes, okay? Two truths and a lie. I don't know which one are true, which one are false. They are all about cars / the car industry. And I have to guess which one is the lie. And if I am wrong, Patrick in Lake Worth wins. So the audience of the show has no faith in me, maybe rightfully so. All right, Louis, here we go. Fact number one. What do you have for me?
Okay, here we go. Hyperinflation and a low supply of inventory helps consumers get a better deal. Truth or lie?
Inflation, low inventory, better deal. Okay. All right, number two.
The 2021 Honda Accord has 7 different models.
2021 Honda Accord has 7 different models. That is clearly worded in a way intelligently to really just put brain in a blender. All right, number three, go ahead.
It's not chemistry. We're not doing calculus. We're just talking cars. Here we go. The last one. All Honda Ridge lines are 2-wheel drives.
Okay, all Honda Ridgeline two-wheel drive. Okay, so I'm going to work backwards.
These are layups, Evan. These are layups.
Jeez, I have the hands tied behind my back. Okay. Jeanette just chimed in on my computer screen, good luck, in big capital letters, laughing at me, knowing this is going to be impossible. Okay, so here we go. All right, don't comment yet. I'm just going to walk everybody through my thought process. Louis will comment at the end. I think the third one, all Honda Ridgeline two-wheel drive, seems false to me because how could there not be four-wheel drive on some of them? The second one, 2021 Honda Accord, is seven different models. I actually think that makes sense, even though I think it's worded in a way for me to think like, oh, a Honda Accord, that is the model. But no, there's models off of, like, Honda Accord is a type of car, but then there's different models within the car. Hyperinflation, low inventory would give somebody a better deal. Wouldn't low inventory give somebody a worse deal, though, I would think, because of the fact that that's, you know, hey, we only have three of these. You're going to have to pay top dollar to get it off the lot. God. Because I don't think I truly understand the first one, I think I'm right about the second one. All right, Louis, here it is. My final answer, I believe, Ed Morse, Morsel of Truth, Louis Heron, I-95, Blue Heron Boulevard, Ed Morse Honda. I believe the lie is the third one. I believe all Honda Ridgelines two-wheel drive is the lie. Louis, the floor is yours.
All right, here we go. I'm going to tell you up front. You got that correct, but you're not as correct as you think. Let me finish.
You
may still have a winner. You may still have a winner. All Honda Ridgelines are two-wheel drives. You said that doesn't sound right because there's got to be some four-wheel drives. There are no four-wheel drives. All Honda Ridgelines are all-wheel drives. Okay, so I don't know. You may want to take care of your caller on that one because that's edgy. Huh. On a 2021 Honda Accord, seven models, that is true. LX, EX, we have a sport model. We have a sport 2.0. We have a special edition, an EXL, and a touring model. Now, the very first one, I threw this in here really to stump you because you answered it well, but I wanted to draw a conclusion and a point for everybody that may not be familiar with. Hyperinflation, low model day supply of total inventory helps the consumer get a better deal. Okay, in hyperinflation, obviously your dollar is worth less. Everything costs more. And I think all of us are experiencing the cost, whether it's at the gas station, whether it's at Publix, and even in automobiles. But what I want to say is if dealers, there's really two ways of looking at this. Right now, the hyperinflation that we're experiencing at a car dealership is inventory is extremely low right now. And over the next 60 days, the inventories will be low, but the production will kick back in July. So I want to encourage everyone, okay? I don't know that I'm the smartest business guy in the world, but typically when dealers have less inventory, they make more money because they have less to sell. My thinking is, knowing the Honda business and knowing the allocation system, the more cars you sell is the more inventory you earn. That's a major factor of the turn and earn allocation system. So if I lay back and I pick and choose which deal I want, when inventories are capable of getting right again in July, I'm going to be short with July and August inventories on the ground. However, if I tell consumers, look, here's the deal. I'm going to take any deal and every deal because I need to keep things moving. Because when I sell the cars in June, in May and June, I'll get all the inventory in July and bank on the fact all the other dealers are holding tight on their cars and trying to make all the money on the cars. They'll be short in July. I'll have all the inventory. My business will keep flowing not only May, not only June, but July through August until the allocations continue to get better. The consumers that buy at Ed Morris Honda is going to still get the phenomenal deal because I got to have inventory on the ground. And we currently have almost 400 new cars to sell from in this whole month. It will be the same in June. So, and that is a low supply, believe it or not. Again, that was a kind of a trick question out there. But I wanted
I'm going to tell you something. I'm going to tell you something. Before we finish on this, when you first said you got it right but not the way you think, I was like, what the heck is Louis talking about here? And as you explained that, you're right. I did get it right. So the caller is wrong because we may have found a loophole in the game, which makes it even more interesting. So I don't think – Jeanette, correct me if I'm wrong here. I don't think I need to be right in my reasoning. I just have to be right in my answer, correct?
Correct.
Okay, so Louis, right. My reasoning was not right, but my answer was right.
Hey, I'm not your therapist. So I think you and I have both equally correct realities, right? Your truth is probably the truth. So I'm going to go with you. I was just thinking of your caller, your show, baby.
Louis, you're the best. We'll talk in a couple of weeks. This is fun as always. It's the little nooks and crannies of this game make it even more fun. Ed Morse, Morsel of Truth, edmorse.com, Ed Morse Honda, I-95, Blue Heron Boulevard. Thank you, Louis. We appreciate it. We'll talk soon.